In this video, we're going to use two methods to find a derivative of a function in which the base will be a number and the variable will be the power. So the reference that we're going to use for the first method will be the fact that b to the x can be written as e to ln b to the x. And that can be equal to, of course, e x ln b. Okay, so b is a constant, of course. Okay, and one thing to note here is that b is greater than zero. Okay, b is greater than zero. Why? Because notice that ln of b can be only valid, can be only defined when b is greater than zero, right? Because the natural logarithm function is undefined when you're taking the ln of zero or the ln of negative numbers, right? So b must be greater than zero. So now the first example that we're going to use this for will be the function fx is equal to 3 to the 2x. So notice that this can be written using the top right-hand corner fact here. It can be written as the b in this case is 3, right? So it can be written as e x ln 3, right? Well, actually, almost. So let's write this. E ln 3 to the 2x. Right, that makes sense, and that will equal e 2x ln 3. Okay? Right, because in this case 2x is substituted for the x. So now it's going to be easy, right? Because you can write this in the form of e ln 3 2x. Okay, so ln 3 is the constant. So when you're going to differentiate this function now, you will write basically itself e ln 3 times the 2x multiplied by the derivative of the power. And the derivative of the power is going to be 2 ln 3. That's it, right? Because the derivative of 2 ln 3 times x is going to be 2 of ln 3. Okay, so let's see, what does that simplify to? That simplifies to 2 ln 3 times, well, let's bracket that, 2 ln 3 times e to the ln 3 x, and we can actually put it in the standard form, because ln of 3 of 2x is equal to 3 of 2x, right? So we can put it as 2 ln 3 times 3 to the 2x, right? We're just substituting back to what it was before. Okay, because e to the ln 3 times 2x was equal to originally this, right? We wrote it so that we can take the derivative easily and then we can substitute. Now the second method of doing it would be to use the logarithmic differentiation method, okay? So if this is equal to that, then you can take the ln on both sides. Ln of f of x is equal to ln of 3 to the 2x. Okay, and this can be written as 2x ln 3. Okay, so now differentiating, we will get, first we're using the chain rule, we're going to do 1 over f of x multiplied by the derivative of the inside, which is f prime of x, and that's what you're going to solve for, right? Is equal to 2 ln 3. So the fx, f prime of x, is going to be this right side multiplied by the function of x. Okay, so it's going to be 2 ln 3 multiplied by the function of x, which is 3 to the 2x. And notice that it matches our final answer here using the first method. Okay, so in the first method, we use the top right-hand corner equivalent substitution in order to differentiate easily, but on the second method, just use the logarithmic differentiation. Okay, let's, I'm going to use the second example now. And I'm going to use the first method, because we actually did use the logarithmic differentiation in my other videos. So just for the sake of using the identity on the top right-hand corner, I'm just going to use that method. If you want, you can use it for the logarithmic differentiation for your own practice, if you'd like. Okay. So now let's substitute this. So 3 to the x squared. So that can be written. So the b is 3. So it can be written as e, and x is substituted for x squared, right? So e to the x squared ln 3, right? That's how it can be substituted. So now the f prime of x in this case, I'm going to separate it from the first example so you're not confused by the f of x. It's a different f of x, obviously. So the f prime of x is going to be equal to e ln 3 ln 3 times x squared multiplied by the derivative of the power, and the derivative of the power will be 2x times ln 3, right? So that should be clear, times 2 ln 3x. I'm just gonna write it like that. Okay, so that should be 2 ln 3 x, and now we can substitute the e to the ln 3 x squared back to 3 to the x squared, right? Okay, so it's going to be equal to times 3 to the x squared. So that's your final answer. Now, once again, use the logarithmic differentiation method just to verify that you'll get the same answer for your own practice. Please subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in my next video.